Hello guys and welcome back to another exciting New Jersey MiniGP race. Today we're racing at the MiniGP Eastern Nationals, which was an exciting race that I've been looking forward to all summer long. The MiniGP guys have opened up both sides of the track, meaning we get to race the full Tempest course. This is the combination of the Liberator and the Avenger tracks, so if you haven't seen those courses before, be sure to check out my previous videos where I've raced on them. The Tempest course is about 1.2 miles and has 18 turns with 2 straightaways, so it makes it for a very challenging course for both racing and tuning. I've opted to gear very tall, going from a 68 rear sprocket up to a 60 rear sprocket. So if you don't already know, this bike is a single variated moped, and it's technically a manual variated CVT. That I control with a launch lever on my foot. So, despite having tall gearing, I will still have great acceleration coming out of the corners thanks to the CVT and manual advancement on my little lever next to my foot. So, as we make our way around the track for our warm-up, let me introduce the lineup. In pole position, there's number one, Brandon Posh. Number 2 is 516, Anthony Maziato. Number 3, number 24, myself. And 4th is number 14, Bill Martin. 5th, number 4, Willie Slunt Jr. 6th position is number 59, Ashley Powell. Number 57, Bob Hines. Followed by 989, Tony Pags. 969 right after is Paul Allison. In 10th position, number 0, Artie Meeker. 329, Jake Leahy. Number 29, Justine Marigalia. 217, William Moore. Number 87, Simon Vanderwall. Number 77, Tommy Maffey. Number 28, Roman Strakowski. 859, Matt Broton. Number 777, Nick Lee Torino. Number 11, Steve Roderick. 20th position, number 8, Dan Zosky. And last, 21st position, number 47, Daryl Foti. So, during qualifying, I was working my way on getting to the front row on a front row position, and just wanted to see where I stood against our world-class racers, Brandon Posh and Anthony Maziato. So, luckily, I got behind them in third, and I was within 1 second of the best lap time held by Brandon Posh. So, we'll see if I could get myself on a podium for the F1 class. So after doing all my last minute checks, make sure everything's all secured on the bike, our flagger will be getting ready to let us go. Tension's rising, I'm getting ready and we're off! And I easily get swallowed up under the acceleration of those powerful supermoto bikes. Gonna try and get around and make a pass on William Slunt on the number 4 bike. Just cut him off on the inside and almost ride him out the course, but luckily we're both in. And now I'm making my way to chase down Brandon Posh and Anthony Maziato. So this section of the course was a little bit difficult for me during practice, and luckily I'm able to keep it together. Coming up on the light bulb turn, tricky turn, you gotta keep yourself on the inside to get through this little chicane area. And here's our first straightaway. And I'm just not confident enough to make a pass on the inside of Anthony Maziato going at that speed. So we're on the downhill right-hander. And going up on the uphill right-hander, another tricky spot of the course. A lot of people get a little bit confused and aren't sure what to do, so it's a challenge. challenging section. And here's our chicane over here that they added in instead of the 90 degree left hander. So they changed that out of the Liberator track. Going a bit wide there. And here we are, back on the straightaway. Giving it all I got. Engine screaming, 13,000 RPMs. And late braking. So that first turn is very similar to the turn at Grange in Apple Valley, so it wasn't too surprising for me to try and get through that turn and learn it, and it wasn't too steep of a learning curve. I know a lot of people going in were coming in at very high speed, and it can be a little bit stressful if you are going fast and you need to make that quick left-hander. So we're going down the straightaway again, hoping to pick up some ground on the straights. I know my bike is probably the fastest and might have about anywhere between 5 to 10 miles per hour higher speed than all of the bikes on the track, but speed isn't everything here. I need to get myself through the corners as fast as I can. I'm just not getting the cornering speed that I need to catch up to these guys. Getting through the next chicane area. And shaking my head because it's a pretty tall task to ask me to catch up to those two guys in the front, but I'm going to make the best of it. As I'm going around these turns, I'm just going to briefly look behind me to make sure that number 4, William Slunt, isn't actually going to come up and creep behind me. During practice and qualifying, I was having a great battle with him, so making sure that I'm ahead and can get all the speed that I can on the straightaways is my top priority. So getting in through this chicane here, which goes downhill. A lot of people tend to take this downhill right-hander part a little too slow. So my advice is, if you're finding yourself losing pace, you might want to check on that corner. A lot of people won't be going too fast. Just pick up some more speed and you'll get through it. It's a little bit scary because you're going down probably full speed before you make that turn, but the bike will keep you alive and keep you up on the track, so just be a little bit confident and commit. Another scary part is that little kink on the straightaway. Most people were dragging their knees all the way through full speed. There's no reason to let off the throttle either, so you can get yourself all the way through. Maybe if you're in the F2 class or the Supermoto class, you might actually count that as a turn. So, coming up to the light bulb. A lot of people were getting past on the inside of this part, and if you go too wide on that turn, you're going to get caught out on the chicane, and you're going to lose a lot of speed trying to get back in. So you can either go in all the way wide on the light bulb and cut in on the inside, or just cut in on the inside the whole way through and just ride it out. It's a great area for a lot of guys to pass and see some passing and action happening. So I still have Anthony and Brandon in my sights, though they're just slowly getting away from me, and not sure how they're able to do it with going to practice in every single class and qualifying in every single class and then racing in every single class. This was probably the 4th race of the day, so I feel like they should be exhausted, but I'll give that to the energy of 13 and 14 year olds who love to race motorcycles, so just can't keep up with them in that department. another tricky area here, that chicane area. You kind of have to go in wide for the left-hand turn and cut in immediately for the right-hand turn. And there's a little patch or broken area in the pavement, and that actually threw me off in practice and I fell over. So just a little bit tricky. Things that you don't really get to see unless you're actually riding on the bike. It's hard to see through the video footage. Coming in and cutting just went a little bit too wide there. I didn't fully make the turn. For that area of the track going on the uphill right-hander, you really have to cut in right-hand on the right-hand part of it. You gotta basically ride on the canny stripe all the way up and just keep turning until the turn is done. If you don't do that, you're gonna get caught out on the turn and someone will pass you because you're either out of gear now, out of the power band or what have you, and you're just in bad position. So coming away on turn one again. And we're pulling in these laps pretty quickly. Our best time for the track during qualifying was 1 minute and 25 seconds. And I was right behind in 1 minute and 26 seconds. So, very fast pace happening in just the F1 class. Straight away again. Another part where you don't necessarily have to let off of the throttle. And it's a section that I'm still learning as I go on through racing at this track and with this group. There are a lot of places where you can improve solely by not coasting. And coasting is probably the worst thing you can do because you're going slower. So if you can get around the fact that you are afraid to brake or need to slow down because you need to coast, you'll be able to pick up some more corner speed and at the same time pick up some overall time on your lap times throughout each lap. So get some confidence, brake a little less, or brake in the proper sections. Make sure you're taking the late apexes that you need, and make sure that your hand is twisted all the way down and you're full throttle all the way through. So another little area here on that track, you see that I'm hitting a bump there. While for the larger bikes it's not too big of a deal, for me it is because of the moped suspension. There are no great aftermarket parts or aftermarket suspension setups that easily adapt to this bike. So everything is a little bit rigid and I have to go through and tune everything. The bike is super lightweight, so any little issue with the track or with my inputs to the controls will unsettle the bike a bit, so it's kind of a maniac to race on. Almost losing it there in the dirt. I think we're coming in on the seventh or eighth lap, and I'm getting pretty tired. There's practice yesterday and driving in all the way from Albany to get down to New Jersey. So it's a little bit exhausting, but you gotta ignore all of that when you're in the middle of a race and just keep on pushing through. Get all your energy. Now, if you're considering racing as just a hobby or what have you, I highly recommend checking out these guys, NJMiniGP. They're super helpful, very well educated in racing and techniques, and the courses here, although you're on a go-kart track racing quote-unquote underpowered bikes compared to say a 600cc or something like that, you will learn a lot more making these quote-unquote slow bikes go fast as opposed to making an already fast bike go fast. You won't learn as much. Here, every bit of input that you do to the bike, tuning and racing alike, will definitely show on the track. So if you're aspiring to test out your tuning abilities, this is a good place for you to get your bike out on the track and see what it's capable of doing. Most of the guys here don't actually do their own tuning, they send it out to shops. Some do, and it definitely shows out on the track. Other guys here are just here to race, and it's fantastic just for that. You show up, pay the track fee, and you get out on the track to race. A full day, you'll probably learn way more going around on the course for one day than you would, you know, taking your superbike out on a track day. So if you're considering getting into this kind of competitive sport, definitely start from the ground up. These guys will love you for it, and they will teach you everything that they have. So I believe we're on the 9th lap here. Getting through the last bit of the course. Last lap flag goes out, and just hoping to finish strong. I've held on to third place this entire time, and the fourth place guy is a bit of ways away from me, maybe about a second and a half, almost 2 seconds behind. So just got to keep it together and hold it down. And this is probably the part where a lot of people take more risks than they need to, or more necessary risks that they should take, especially if you're battling out for first place. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to get up to the first two guys, but for me, it was just a matter of keeping it together, keeping the bike together, and keeping myself in the game, and not taking any unnecessary risks to throw away third place. As you can see, my pace even has slowed down a bit. I wouldn't be surprised if the lap time for this section of the track was maybe a couple seconds slower. But finish strong, and just keep myself prepared for the next time that I'm coming out here. And there you have it. Third place secured. It's been a long time coming for this bike and myself. Definitely excited about that. Definitely looking forward to moving up into either second or first for the next race. Now that I'm very comfortable after one season riding out here and seeing what everyone else is capable of, seeing myself improve over the past couple races. It's just a great feeling. So, thanks for watching. If you guys have any comments or questions, leave it down in the section below. Be sure to subscribe so you can check out more of my commentaries. I also do tuning advice and, you know, just a bit of motor vlogging. So be sure to check those videos out. And if you have any suggestions for future videos, anything that you would like to see, let me know. So thanks for watching. See you guys later.